فإن آمنوا بمثل ما آمنتم به فقد اهتدوا وإن تولوا فإنما هم في شقاق.
This lecture will be for this lecture is more for the sisters, but will be done from here. And the sisters, they have that center room, that middle room. It's better if there's no kids of an age where they are somewhat difficult to control. The brothers can participate by listening. All the questions will be taken from only the sisters' side. And the title of the lecture is concerning mannerism, or the manners and characteristics of the Muslim woman.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على محمد رسول الله سيد الأولين والآخرين وإمام الأنبياء والمرسلين والشافع المشفع يوم الدين وعلى آله الطيبين وأزواجه الطاهرات أمهات المؤمنين وصحابته الغر الميامين ومن استنى بسنته واهتدى بهديه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، as you hear that the topic which is given for this time is related to the Muslim woman character, and it is on manners and characters that she need to be upon. Although that these are not specifically characters and manners, these are not character and manners that to be specifically for women. But it is a reminder, otherwise men and women need to also be upon this type of manners and characters. But because women are creation where Allah Ta'ala stored with them the reasons or causes of tranquility in the house. As Allah Ta'ala said, قُلْنَا لِبَاسٌ لَكُمْ جَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. They are a coverage matter for you, for the men. And here Allah Ta'ala said that they are a source of tolerance and tranquility. And also Allah Ta'ala have given the example to the believers by the woman, although it is the example to all mankind, not only women but men and women as well. كما قال سبحانه وتعالى, as Allah Ta'ala said in Surah Tahrim, الآية 10 ضرب الله مثلا للذين كفروا امرأة نوح وامرأة لوط كانتا تحت عبدين من عبادنا صالحين فخانتاهما فلم يغنيا عنهما من الله شيئا. Allah sets forth an example for those who disbelieve the wife of Nuh and the wife of Lut. They were under two of our righteous slaves. We all know that Lut and Nuh were prophets, messengers. But they both betrayed them. Now, betrayed them here does not necessarily mean in the honor, but it is in rejecting their call to worship Allah alone and decided to be with the kuffar, the enemies of these prophets. فَلَمْ يُغْنِيَا عَنْهُمَا مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا. So they both, Nuh and Lut, availed them not against Allah, and it was said, اُدْخُلَا الْجَنَّةَ اُدْخُلَا النَّارَ مَعَ الدَّاخِلِينَ. It was said to them, to those two women, enter the fire along with those who enter, meaning with those people of the fire. Also, Allah Ta'ala gave the example to the believers, as He gave it to the disbelievers, He gave to the believers. Also with women. وضرب الله مثلا للذين آمنوا امرأة فرعون إذ قالت رب ابن لي عندك بيتا في الجنة ونجني من فرعون وعمله ونجني من القوم الظالمين. And Allah has set forth an example for those who believe, meaning men and women, the wife of Fir'aun. When she said, Oh my Lord, build for me a home with you in paradise and save me from Fir'aun and his work, meaning the shirk, and save me from the people who are ظالمين, the wrongdoers, the disbelievers, the politicians. Same thing Allah Ta'ala said about Maryam alayhi salam, وَمَرْيَمَ ابْنَةَ عِمْرَانَ الَّتِي أَحْصَنَتْ فَرْجَهَا فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِنَا وَصَدَّقَتْ بِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّهَا وكتبه وكانت من القانتين. And Maryam, the daughter of Imran, who guarded her chastity. And we breathed into the sleeve of her shirt, meaning her garment, through our Ruh, which is Jibreel alayhi salam, meaning that Allah commanded Jibreel to blow in the sleeve of the garment of Maryam alayhi salam, and she testified. Now, this blow is for the pregnancy of Isa alayhi salam, because Maryam alayhi salam was virgin, was never been told. And she testified to the truth of the words of her Lord. And the books of her Lord so Allah Ta'ala said to her be with the qanitin which are the obedient to Allah the believers so as we see now these are two examples that Allah Ta'ala gave to the believers and these examples are are of women and that's why we need to give much care to the Muslim women in regard to the manners and characters and this should start from the childhood whoever has a daughter whoever is given and blessed with a daughter he should then raise her he should raise her up upon these good manners and characters and the first manner and character that we want to talk about is honesty the Muslim woman must be honest in her belief when she says that she is Muslim and she only worships Allah and also in whenever she speaks she must be honest she should not tell lies because she's a believer and Allah Ta'ala said in the Quran ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha wa kunu ma'a as-sadiqin oh you who believe fear Allah and be from amongst the honest ones فعلى المرأة المسلمة أن تتقي الله عز وجل في اعتقادها وفي كلامها. So she, the Muslim woman, must fear Allah Ta'ala in her belief and in her speech. And only be upon truthfulness and honesty. The second manner is what we call al-amana or the trustworthiness because Allah Ta'ala says وَأَدُّوا الْأَمَانَاتِ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا وَأَدُّوا الْأَمَانَاتِ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا and convey the trusts to their owners فلا يجوز لامرأة so it's not permissible for any Muslim woman to deceive or cheat so she must give the trust to their owners والله أن الله عز وجل an attribute the believers in general and of course the woman is one of them the Muslim woman is one of them one of those who are targeted with this speech when Allah Ta'ala says when he described the believers he said وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ And they are the ones who give care and take care of their trustworthiness and obligations. وأيضا من الخلق and also from the manners and characters that the Muslim woman need to be upon is chastity. As we hear the ayah in Surah Al-Tahrim when Allah Ta'ala spoke about Maryam alayhi salam, He Allah Ta'ala described her by that she maintained her chastity and guarded her chastity. And to maintain and guard the chastity of the woman, she needs not to be seen in the crowds which is of men and women. She must not be seen commonly or often in the markets. She must not be seen. She must not be seen in places where it is free mixing. Unless it is a necessity of emergency that she needs to go through. Otherwise, this is from the chastity, not to be seen out. And also not to expose her body parts. Even the one or the parts that the ulama have different opinions in regard, like the face. She should not expose her face because the different opinions of the scholars never contain the forbidding of covering the face. But it was about whether it is obligatory or recommended. And none of our ulama said that it is forbidden for a woman to cover her face unless if she is in the ihram state. And that's Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam who said that it is forbidden for her to cover her face when she is in the ihram state. So the Muslim believer woman should cover her face whenever she is by the presence of stranger men, and that is part of the chastity. Not only that, but Allah Ta'ala even said that she must speak in a very respectful way when she speaks to stranger men, and not to soften her voice, not to break up her speech, because this will attract the one with weak iman, the one who has disease in his heart. ولا يخضعن بالقول فيطمع الذي في قلبه مرض وقلنا قولا معروفا. And also from the chastity that she does not talk to men over the internet or any other means like chatting means, or and whenever she is in need to enter to internet, she enters as needed and necessary and necessary, and that's it. Because some women finds it okay to keep talking to men, and they say it is over the internet. But that is not correct. That brings the fitna. And it is seen, I don't say sometimes, but it is more often seen between men and women chatting on the internet that they collapse and fall into the haram. And the fourth manner and character that we advise our sister to be upon is modesty. She must be modest, not to be like some woman, very bold. She speaks about anything with anyone. Now, modesty must be seen on the Muslim woman. She's not a Kaaba no more. She reverted. Now she has to realize that this life is different from the previous life that she used to have. She is now a Muslim. She has a big responsibility now. She has a big responsibility now. So she must be modest. The fifth is tolerance. She must be a woman who is tolerant and not to get nervous and angry just that quick. This can be something that she is born with, meaning tolerance and control over herself and her anger, but could be also something that she can earn. As the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ بِالتَّعَلُّمُ وَإِنَّمَا الْحِلْمُ بِالتَّحَلُّمُ. Knowledge is found by seeking it, meaning gradually and for long terms. Likewise, حِلْم, which is tolerance, can be earned also, but like ilm. You cannot have it at once like that. But you have to exercise it and train yourself with it. And the sixth manner, the character of the Muslim woman that she should be upon is generosity and kindness. She must not be selfish. The Prophet ﷺ said to the woman, لا تمنعن جارة جارتها ولو فرس نشاه. Let the female neighbor not to refuse lending anything to her female neighbor, even if it is a person shah. Person shah is the hoof of the goat, which is, you know, less worthy for people to use. It is something very unusual. But if the neighbor asks for it, the Muslim woman should not refuse to lend it. Not only that, but I mean that is the lowest, and then she goes on and on to be one of the characters of Islam. And the seventh is patience. And that is the thing that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in his hadith when he said, وَمَا أُعْطِيَ أَحَدٌ عَطَاءً أَوْسَعَ لَهُ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ. No one is giving anything more worthy than patience. The worthiness here is before Allah, not in this worldly life. Although it has يعني, a type of fruits in يعني, here in this life, this worldly life, but it is more worthy in the hereafter. And this thing, patience, is something that Allah Ta'ala mentioned a lot in the Quran. Mentioned a lot. Allah commanded His Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to be abundant. He said, فَاصْبِرْ كَمَا صَبَرَ أُولُو الْعَزْمِ الرُّسُلِ. Be patient as أُولُو الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ. أُولُو الْعَزْمِ from amongst the messengers were patient. Who أُولُو الْعَزْمِ? They are five. Nuh, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, and Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They're the ones who faced a lot of troubles from their people. And the eighth character and manner is what we call it in Arabic, حُسْنُ التَّبَعُلُ, meaning to be a very good wife. By that meaning, very good wife. In her work and her house, the lack of cleanliness, cooking food, taking care of the children, and preparing herself for her husband. And that's why Rasulullah ﷺ said in the hadith that the woman must obey her husband when he asks her for his needs, even if she is up on the back of a camel, meaning she's ready to travel. And he asks her for her need, his need, she has to come down and allow him and then go. Even when she is up on the tandoori or the oven baking bread. And you know that baking bread does not take time. Maybe when you cook meat and rice, this takes time. She can leave it on fire and go obey her husband for his need and come back and the food is still not burnt. But when it is baking bread, for example, it does not wait for that time. It cannot wait for the time. So what should she do? Whisk the bread, let it burn? Yes. If the husband calls her for his need, she has to go, even if the consequence of that is the damage of the bread. That's what Rasulullah said. وَلَوْ كَانَتْ عَلَى التَّنُّورِ. Even if she is up on the, yani by the oven baking. And also, from this character, حسن التبعل, is as Isa Sallam said to the man, to the men, marry al-wadud al-walud. Al-wadud, he said, marry al-wadud al-walud. These are two attributes of the Muslim woman. Al-wadud means the lover, the one who has emotion. How can a man know that this woman has emotion and love and like that? The ulama said from the other members of the family. Because she is not going to be yani, a flower inside plenty of needles or thorns. But a flower is going to be found in the garden with other flowers. So you check with the rest of the woman's family members, female members, how they are. You can ask, you know, you can ask your relatives, female relatives, and they're going to tell you that this woman is soft and mashallah, yani, polite and easy, or the opposite. if she is the opposite, don't come close. Because some women are very tough. Some women are very tough. As the Prophet ﷺ told that woman who came and asked about three men who proposed her at the time, she said, I'm confused who to marry. And she named them. He said that Abu Jaham is somebody who never puts the stick down, meaning that he's tough. He's tough and he's hard and harsh. So it is, yeah, and I advise not to marry him. Also, he said to the man, Al-Wadud, take Al-Wadud, the one which has love to her husband. Yeah? So this is from Husn al-Taba'ur, from being good wife. From Husn al-Taba'ur also, is that once she knows that this is the time for her husband to come, she go and take shower, and put on the best clothes, and wear perfume, and you know, prepare his clothes for him, and the warm shower, whatsoever. As once he opens the door, she smiles and give him salam, and you know, respond to salam like that. And then she also, like the wife of Abu Talha, when he came from the battle, she was very well dressed in a very attractive way, and she served him the dinner. He ate good food, and then when he ate the good food, he enjoyed it. After he finished all, she asked him, saying, see if Allah Ta'ala put a trust with you. And then he asked you to return it back. Would you reject? Would you refuse? He said, no. She said, then the amana that Allah Ta'ala gave you, your son, Allah Ta'ala has taken, meaning he died. See how that woman was, how a good wife she was. Not like many wives today, waiting for her husband to open the door and start screaming and fight. And the gas is, we run out of gas, no electricity, no salt, no water, no this, no that, no this, no that, and you are. That woman didn't do that. The man left home going for battle to be killed there, not to go and bring her money. He was going there to die fi sabilillah, fight against the kuffar. And when he left home, his son was very ill. So when he came back, first thing he asked when he entered, how's the baby? She said, MashaAllah, it is very quiet. Very quiet. And of course, he's very quiet, he's dead already. He already died. So, after he enjoyed her, at the dinner enjoyed her, she said to him, she did not say, oh, your son died. No, she said, in a very clever way, what if Allah Ta'ala, she said, what if somebody gave you a trust, property or whatsoever, money to save for him? And then he came back and asked you his belongings. Are you going to give it to him or you deny it? He said, no, I'll have to give it to him. She said, then Allah Ta'ala kept your son as a trust or as something to say with you, and he talked. See how quiet and gentle she was. Usually, when a child dies, the woman is more affected than the man. The mother more affected than the father. You might see the father sad, but the woman crying day and night. She might not sleep, she might not eat. This does not mean that this woman did not like her baby. She liked him very much. But she's a believer. She is a believer woman who acted up on these guidances from Allah Ta'ala and Rasulullah. So the woman must be upon, as we call it, husn al-taba'ul, meaning to be a good wife. A good wife. From husn al-taba'ul, ya ikhwan, also we're going to talk about this in the ninth character, but from husn al-taba'ul is not to object polygamy. Not to object it. However, the best quality of husn al-taba'ul is to call your husband to marry another one. Especially when you live in such a place in the West, where you know more than anyone else that the men here do not take only one woman. You know the things happening even to the high level people here, and there was some of them over 60. Why is that? It is because the women object polygamy. But they, as they say in the poetry of wisdom, it is said in Arabic, ألقاه باليم مكتوفا وقال له إياك إياك أن تبتل بالماء. He tied his hand to his back and thrown him to the middle of the sea and warned him not to get wet. How come it? Now, you're living here in the West and asking the man not to see nothing. How come? If he is blind, he's going to see. If he is blind, he's going to see this rubbish in the streets. What about it when he is not blind and he can't see and he goes to war and how can he protect himself? How can he protect himself? And also, even if the husband can't control himself, what about that other sister? A study made on the rivers in the West, and it was found that the rivers amongst females is 3 times more than the rivers from males. So now, this is a woman who just came to Islam. Before Islam, she had many relations. She can have a relation every day. And no one blames her in the West. No one finds it wrong. The governments even help them, give them benefits and support, and social support. Now she became Muslim. She needs a man. She needs a man. But the Muslim sister who is married to a man refuses that her husband marry that sister. That's wrong. That's wrong, ya ikhwah. This is not from the good of from the husn al-taba'ul, the good or being good wife. Good Muslim wife should ask her husband, please marry another one, because we need to have this type of brotherhood and cooperation between the Muslims. And I know, I hear of many sisters who rejected Islam back again and went to Jahiliyyah because no any help is given to her once she became Muslim. No any help is given to her. It is not wrong for the Muslim sister to ask her husband to marry another one. Because we saw when the Sahaba migrated to Medina, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم set a brotherhood between every two companions, عبد الرحمن بن عوف and Sa'd ibn Mu'adh were brothers in that movement. I forgot if it's Sa'd ibn Mu'adh or other than him, but one of the Ansar. This Ansari said to عبد الرحمن بن عوف, look, I have يعني big wealth, I'll divide it into two, one share for you, one share for me. And I have two wives. He did not say, I'm going to divorce one and you marry her. He said, look to which one you like more. Because that time yet the hijab is not obligatory. So he said to him, look to which one you like more, I divorce her and you marry her. Look at that. So today the Muslim sister, and I hope this talk can make the change. And I wish that when I come back again, I find sisters more than brothers saying Jazakallahu khair with guidance. Because now we have husbands, we have somebody who take care of us in this land where the woman is the most easy target. The woman here is like a deer living in a lion land, in a land of lions. What do you think lion is going to do with the lion, with the deer? Rob over her. They're gonna eat her. So what do you think the people here are going to do? When especially when the kuffar finds that this house has only one woman living there and she is Muslim. She's wearing hijab. They are going to accuse her. And maybe they are going to rape her. And that happened a lot. We don't want to lie to each other and say, no, this here cannot happen. No. If it can happen anywhere, it would be in the West. So we need to give some shelter and some support, not only from the kuffar that, or from the others, not to accuse the woman, but also from her desire. From her desire, from the shaitan. And the Prophet ﷺ said, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. One of you would not be a believer until he likes for him, for his brother, what he likes for himself. So you, sister, like to stay with your husband in this marriage. You don't like to be divorced. You don't like to be seen alone. You don't want to go back to your non-Muslim house or family because you are going to face a lot of troubles. Now you are, alhamdulillah, Muslim in a Muslim house, having a Muslim husband. Okay, why don't you like this from your sister? Why don't you go forth and, you know, work on yani, this thing to happen? It's not only we talk, no, we need to practice that. Especially here, as I said. And this is the 9 points that I prepared, sacrificing for the sake of Allah, of course, first of all, of Islam, and also of the family. Some sisters say, if you go and marry another woman, you have to divorce me. Subhanallah, where is your iman? Where is your iman? Where is your iman? Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, any woman asks a divorce from her husband with no valid reason, she would never smell the smell of the Jannah. She will never even find the smell of the Jannah. Not enter, not the smell. The smell she cannot find. Today women prefer to go to fire but not to have a polygamy marriage. That's wrong, ikhwan. And the funny thing, the very funny thing, is when the second wife refuses the third. Subhanallah. You accepted to be second, and now you say, no, I can't make it. You can't take a third one. That even, yeah, very strange. So to protect the family and household and the family here in the West is one castle of Islam. We have to protect it. Do not break the family for such a reason. I'd rather say that you should ask your husband to marry another one and help him finding a good wife, a good sister of yours. Ramla bint Habib, Ramla bint Abi Sufyan Umm Habiba, the mother of believers, when she heard that Rasulullah ﷺ, wants to marry another one. She did not object it. She came to him, she said, Ya Rasulullah, if you want to marry another one, then take my own sister. Because she is the closest one to me and I love her very much. So we are not going to have problems. He laughed at her and he said, don't you know that it is not permissible for a man in Islam to marry two sisters, and your sister is my sister in breastfeeding. So the Muslim woman need to be a good wife, as we said earlier, and sacrifice for the sake of the family, not to break it. Meaning, she must be patient and accept the polygamy. And ask your husband if he wants to marry another one. If he says no, encourage him, discuss it with him. Why? Why? We have a tribe in Saudi that if the wife, after 1 year marriage, she started eating the ear of the husband. Not eating by the meaning of eating, but by speaking about polygamy. Why don't you marry another one? Why don't you marry another one? Why don't you marry another one? You know why? Because if the first year passes and he has only one wife, all the women in the tribe, in the village, boycott her and speak ill of her and say, you are a bad woman. How come your husband doesn't marry another one? Why don't you encourage him? I'm sure now all the brothers will say, which tribe is this, we're going to marry from there. Because most of the women today refuse the polygamy. But we want to expand that tribe in Saudi to be worldwide. And it would be a brand for the Muslim woman to marry, to allow her husband to marry more than one. Not only that, but she must object him staying with her alone. And also, this would make the responsibility lesser with you, sister. If you are married to one husband, that means you have to work every day. When he has other family, other wife, he'd be one day here, one day there. So in the day he is there, you can rest. You don't need to wash the clothes, you don't need to work, because he is now there. Huh? You don't need to cook much. And if he has three wives, oh, you have 2 days rest. And when he has four wives, you're lucky. You're lucky. 3 days rest. There is no work can give you 3 days rest. But polygamy can guarantee you 3 days rest. Pay. So we need to retrieve this again and again and speak about it more often and more wide. Also, from the manners and characters that the Muslim women need to be upon, or to stay away from. Here, the last three are manners and characters that we need the Muslim woman to stay away from. These are what Allah Ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Hujurat, as you all hear the brother in Surah Al-Maghrib recited, where Allah Ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Where Allah Ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, la yaskhar qawmun min qawm. عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم ولا نساء من نساء عسى أن يكن خيرا منهن ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان ومن لم يتب فأولئك هم الظالمون. Oh, you who believe, let not a group scoff at another group. And maybe that the latter are better than the former. Nor let some woman scoff at other woman. It might be that the latter be better than the former. Nor defame one another. Nor insult one another by nicknames. How bad is it to insult one's brother after having faith and becoming Muslim? And whosoever does not repent and from these things, then such are indeed the ظالمين or wrongdoers. So here we have three bad or negative characters that Muslim women need to stay away. And these seen amongst all Muslims, but more often seen from the women. From the women. Scoff at one another. And defame one another with names, with nicknames which are bad and unaccepted by the one who's been defamed. And insulting one another, especially in the polygamy marriages. You see one insulting the other, defaming her, scoffing at her. And also, as Allah Ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِنَ الظَّنِّ إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ إِثْمٌ. Are you believe? Avoid much suspicion. Indeed, some suspicion are sins. Allah Ta'ala said, avoid much suspicion. Indeed, some suspicion are sins. So you avoid the much because some is sin, are sins. But suspicion is found when polygamy is found. She is this, she is that. If the husband does by mistake anything in house A, wife A says that it has been instructed by house B. She told you to do this. By Allah, no, I know. She doesn't like me, she this, she that. And they are giving the bigger chance to shaitan to work even comfortably. So the advice to the Muslim woman is to fear Allah and be upon these manners and characters, and end up here by a reminder from a hadith where he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا صَلَّتِ الْمَرْأَةُ فَرْضَهَا. When the Muslim woman practice the prayers, the obligatory prayers, وَصَامَتْ شَهْرًا, fast the month of Ramadan, وَأَطَاعَتْ زَوْجَهَا, and obeyed her husband, وَحَفِظَتْ فَرْجَهَا, and protected her chastity, قِيلَ لَهَا ادْخُلِ الْجَنَّةَ مِنْ أَيَّ أَبْوَابِهَا شِئْتِ, and it will be said to her, enter the Jannah from any gate you like. And one day the Prophet ﷺ saw a woman and he asked her, do you have a husband? She said, yes. He said, how are you to him? She said, I'm good to him. He said, good, because he is your Jannah or your fire. Meaning, because of him, you either enter the Jannah or enter the fire. Because of him, because of the husband. So the advice to the Muslim woman, if she is a wife, to take care of the house, obey the husband, prepare herself always. No arguments, try always to avoid arguments. If there are any shortcomings from the husband, try to address it in a nice way, indirectly, with praising. And if the husband asks for polygamy, she should not object. If he doesn't ask, she should investigate. She should investigate this man. Why? This is not normal. Maybe the man is sick. It's not normal that her husband doesn't want to marry again. Maybe he is too tired of her. Maybe she is terrifying him enough not even to speak about polygamy. As I know some men, once the word polygamy is spoken, they run away, afraid of a spy speaking about, you know, like if they are speaking about politics. You know, they are more terrified of their wives than even the what do you call that, M5 or what?
MI5.
Because once the wife hears that her husband spoke about polygamy or sat to a lesson where polygamy is spoken about, then the house is going to chill, going to, the relation going to freeze, and the house going to be on fire. So Muslim women need to fear Allah. And fearing Allah is not only to pray and this, no. Fearing Allah is also in your relation to your husband, and also to your community and your Muslim sisters. You need to check why this woman has no husband. She just came to Islam. All of the rest of the relatives, the rest of the family are kuffar. How can she go and stay there? Where she's going to stay? Who is going to take care of her? We need to cooperate on birr and taqwa. We need to help one another. We need to be seen by all the people that this religion has made a change on us. Let people like Islam through you, by you. Be the good example that people take as a method of call to Islam without even speaking. May Allah Ta'ala protect us all from the plans of Shaitan and make us all awliya of Ar-Rahman and bestow love in our hearts towards one another, and make all the husbands and wives love each other, be kind to each other.
فإن آمنوا بمثل ما آمنتم به فقد اهتدوا وإن تولوا فإنما هم في شقاق